Hello everybody, this is Jerry. Fair warning, this is my first attempt at a video, so bear with me here. This one here, I'm going to go around the outside of our camper and show it to you. A lot of people that have visited our site have asked about the camper, wanted to see it, and of course you know we have a lot of pictures there, but no videos. So I'm going to go ahead and go around the outside. I apologize in advance, it's a little breezy today, so you might hear a little wind noise. And the camera might be a little shaky from time to time, but that's all right. And here we go. And we'll start off right back here at the back of the camper. And across the top there, I took those lights off and resealed all of those to get those ready. And what you see at the very top there is the rain cap, and that prevents water from running down the side of the camper. And so we don't get black streaks. And then there's a reflectors that I added to it, a little more visibility, one on the other side. A big decal on the back. Nobody sees that when we have the blue boy up here. I'm still in the cleaning process, so that's why the spare tire cover looks a little moldy there. We have a mold problem in the winter time around here. That's the blue boy carrier that I fabricated. It has used to be a hand truck. And I cut off the wheels and the top of the handle, and I padded the foot of it, and then used square U-bolts and attached it to the bumper, and that is where our 42-gallon Barker Blue Boy rides. And also, I replaced the regular tail lights with LEDs. I added those reflectors, but I think I'm going to take those off and get something else. I don't like the way that looks anymore. We'll come around here, and there's our electrical inlet. And the lights there, and the outside shower, and the cable TV inlet. I took all of those off and resealed them, cleaned them, resealed them. And then we're gonna drop down here, and hopefully you can see that. The little white thing you see right there at the edge, that is where my Tornado black tank rinser connects. I can hook a water line right there, and it rinses out the black tank for me, which is the tank on the right. The square white thing you see there, that is where we store our sewer hose. And that is a regular plastic fence post and cap from Lowe's. And I cut it to size, and the sewer hose fits right in there. Since it's plastic, it'll never rust. And I have a little drain hole in the bottom, so if any liquid will drain out. Of course, our gray tank there on the left. And then, of course, and there's a 10-foot section of hose there. And of course, in our bumper, which I have right now I have a paper towel stuck in there because I've been working out here, and there's 50,000 wasps looking for a place to build a nest. And I don't want them in there. And there's another 10-foot section of hose in the bumper. Of course, that's a spare. We rarely have to use it. Here's our water heater. We have screens, of course, to keep the mud daubers out of there. And if you'll notice the little clip on there, is made out of metal. I removed the plastic one that came from the factory and replaced it with the metal one because the metal is not going to break as easy as a plastic one. And the little louvered section there, you can't see it from this side, but I took a little piece of metal screen and cut it to fit and sealed that up on the side. So, you know, air still flows through freely, but bugs cannot get in there. I do not want any mud daubers in my water heater. And of course, there is our refrigerator vent. The same thing, I have screens under there to keep everything out. Of course, our double axles. There is the furnace exhaust. Once again, we have mud dauber screens on there to keep them out of there, because if you ever get them in there, it is nothing but trouble. That is the exhaust vent for over the stove, and it's closed. We only open it when we stop. That's the window over the sink, and that's a window, it's about at the foot of the bed, actually. And if you look up on this side here, you'll see the rain cap on this side here, the refrigerator vent. And the little black thing you see up there, of course, is one of our solar panels. And the rain cap, I said, keeps the water off of the camper. And I have not washed the camper since we put it away in November. And there are no black streaks. And then here we go with our water inlets. The one on the left, you know, just fills up the tank. The one on the right, the city water connection. The little plastic thing over the city water connection got pretty moldy over the winter, and I had to go down to the local RV dealer and purchase a new one to put on there. $5 for a little plastic thing. And in our front storage bay, we have the things that we use on this side of the camper. Of course, the water hose and the support for the sewer hose, and a few other things that we don't have to use very often, but it's there. And we'll try to get in here and see if the camera will focus on there, but you'll see our Samlex 300 watt pure sine wave inverter, and that powers our TV and satellite and our phone chargers and laptop chargers and so forth when we're boondocking. And you can see a little bit of it through the hose over there, the back. That is the solar charge controller, and that's what keeps our batteries quite charged. We love that solar. And here on the front of the camper, I'll step back so you can see the whole thing. And if you'll notice, there is no decal on the front. The one that came on the camper started cracking and peeling, so we took it off. And we're having a custom decal made for us. And if you visit our website, you'll be able to see what that decal is going to look like. In our propane tanks, and I have the cover off because I was fiddling with that. And our Barker VIP, 3,500 pound electric tongue jack. I love that thing. This little cover that's on it, Barker sent me that for free. I asked where I could buy a cover, and they said, we'll give you one. And there is our automatic changeover regulator. And if you'll notice, it is not on top of this bar. I have it down here, and it's secured in place with a heavy-duty wire tie just above each one of these sections, so it holds it in place. So when I have to remove a tank, I don't have to fiddle with the regulator dangling. This little black thing here is a indicator inside the camper. This wire goes to inside the camper, and when it draws off of one tank at a time, and when one tank goes empty, the automatic changeover regulator will draw from the other. Whenever that changeover occurs, a signal is sent through that wire, and it lights a light up inside the camper, so I know I have an empty tank. And then I can come out here, simply flip this lever to point to the other tank. I can safely remove the empty tank and go have it filled while still drawing from the other tank. Now I'm going to look into my toolbox that I added here. As you'll see, I have my batteries in there. The batteries don't have the covers on them right now. They're in the containers, but they don't have the lids on it. And if you look at that little hole right there in the top, that's the vent that goes out. And of course, there's a few vents at the bottom on the back that point downward. And those are my quick disconnects, so I can disconnect the batteries. And of course, the shunt for the charge controller and the fuse. And then some of this stuff is some things aren't normally in here. I've just been fiddling with the camper over the winter, trying to get everything ready. So we're making sure that it's good to go. Okay, on the other side of the camper, here we go. Our 15-foot awning. I'll step back a little bit, and you can see the storage there. Our gas grill is in there. There's the Blue Boy. It's normally on the mount on the back of the camper, but while I was cleaning, I just stuck it under there. And as you can see, it has pneumatic tires on it. We replaced the plastic ones. Another decal, we're going to get rid of that and put our custom decal on there. And of course, I got the door open because I've been in and out of the camper today. And that on the door, you can see the grab handle that we installed. And the middle section is clear. It used to be solid white, and which was a pain when you had just a screen door closed and you tried to look out the door. It was, that whole section was blocked. So we bought a clear section and put it on there. And if you'd like to get any of the modifications that we've done on our camper, just go to our website and look at the mods page, and there's links to everything for you. And there's my oh no handle that I installed. When I come out of there and I trip and fall and I go, oh no, I have something to grab hold of. And there is our air conditioner, and you can barely see the other solar panel. And that's it on the outside of the camper. And I hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, if you go to our website at rvroadtrip.us, and on the menu on the right, you can go to the RVers library to find out how we did some things. You can also go to the mods page and see all the modifications that we've done. And if there's something that you'd like to see a video of, just let us know, and we'll try to get it done. Thank y'all, and have a blessed day.